weary over many a quiet and curious volume of forgotten lore. While I nodded, nearly napping, suddenly there came a tapping as someone gently rapping at my chamber door. "'Tis some visitor," I muttered, tapping at my chamber door. Only this and nothing more. The bleak December, and each separate dying ember wrought its ghost upon the floor. Eagerly I wished the morrow, vainly I had sought to borrow from my books surcease of sorrow for the lost, Lenore for the rare and radiant maiden from the angels named Lenore, nameless here forevermore. Open here! I flung the shutter when, with many a flirt and flutter, in there stepped a stately raven of the saintly days of yore. Not the least obeisance made he, not a minute stopped or stayed he, but with mind of lord or lady perched above my chamber door, perched and sat and nothing more. Then this ebony bird beguiling my sad fancy into smiling by the grave and stern decorum of countenance it wore. "Though my crest be shorn and shaven, thou," I said, "art sure no craven, ghastly, grim, and ancient raven, wandering from the nightly shore. Tell me what thy lordly name is on this night's Plutonian shore." Quoth the raven, "Nevermore." But the raven, sitting lonely on the placid bust, spoke only that one word, as if his soul, that one word he did outpour. Nothing farther than he uttered, not a feather than he fluttered, till I scarcely then muttered, "Other friends have flown before. On the morrow he will leave me, as my hopes have flown before." And then the bird said, "Nevermore." Then methought, as the air grew denser, perfume from such an unseen censer swung by the seraphim whose footfalls tickle on the tufted floor. "Wretch," I cried, "thy God hath lent thee, by these angels hath sent thee respite and lament thee from thy memories of Lenore. Quaff this kind of pen, and forget this lost Lenore." Quoth the raven, "Nevermore." Ooh, be that word or sign of parting, bird or fiend, I shriek upstarting, "Get thee back into the tempest of night's Plutonian shore. Leave no black gloom as a token that lion that soul has spoken. Leave my loneliness unbroken. Quit the bust above my door. Take thy beak from out thy heart, from out my heart, and take thy form off my door." Quoth the raven, "Nevermore."
Yeah, any place where jazz is played is a sacred place. So since you're in church, everybody stand up. Everybody's here. Yeah, put your hands in the air. Wave them like you just don't care. Say, oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Quoth the raven, yeah, nevermore.
And the raven never flitting, still is sitting, still is sitting on the pallet bust of palace. Just above my chamber door, his eyes have all the seeming of a demon's that is dreaming. And the lamplight over him is streaming. Throw his shadow on the floor, and my eyes saw from out that shadow that lies floating on the floor, floating on the floor, shall be lifted, shall be lifted. Shall be lifted nevermore.
Everybody.
Nevermore. Nevermore.